สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to NNT News Talk brought to you by the National News Bureau of Thailand. My name is Cholapansa Narula, your host. The term creative economy is something we hear quite often in recent months. It's one of the most anticipated campaigns launched by the government in order to promote the innovative minds amongst the local business operators with the rich Thai culture, our local wisdoms, and a lot of things that we have here in Thailand. Through this concept, it could actually generate a lot of revenue for the country. How can technology play a part in this development? Today we have invited the Executive Director of NECTECH, Dr. Pansak Sirirachatapong, to give us more information about this. Swadika, Doctor.
Swadika.
Good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining the program. First of all, tell us a bit about creative economy in the opinion of NECTECH. How do you view this particular concept?
Yes, I think we can define creative economy in many ways, but for the simple explanation, maybe I think it's just the how you can create a new idea that can help you improve your product to satisfy your customers, or how you can differentiate your product from the others to be more competitive. This is the main two things. The first one, how you can know the other one in the world right now, you can learn many information from the internet. Mm-hmm. So for the first thing is you can learn and educate yourself by using the internet, the information in the internet. And the more you learn, the more you have the new ideas. And the more the new ideas is you can think the other one. This is a creative economy, ideas and ideas and ideas. But to realize the new idea to be the real things that can deliver to the customer and convert to the economy is another thing.
Mm-hmm.
So to convert the idea to the real product or service, you need some certain technologies.
Indeed.
Yeah. I think that the main ICT, electronic and computer or software, permits on the idea to be the real one, using the new application software, design the new products. This is why the electronic and computer, or in the, I think, simple term, ICT, is very crucial and important role to help the creative economies.
So technology can play an important part,
yes,
in helping, yeah, put the ideas into action,
yes,
or into,
yes,
practice.
Yes, yes.
Now, recently, the NECTECH organized a special seminar about ECT technology.
Yes.
Tell us a bit about this, and how is it going to help develop all the creative economy concepts?
Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, that this electronic and computer technology is very crucial for helping you have a new idea and convert the new idea to be a real one. But in reality, electronic computer is quite wide, and we have to specify a little bit more precisely. For example, we divide into four categories. The first one is electronic technologies. Mm-hmm. This is the many people know as the hardware technology, like the sensors, the equipment in the instrument that help the people to know exactly what is the condition in some environment. Like we measure the temperature,
mm-hmm,
measure the humidity, for example. The second one is the computing. Computing is the term that we process the data. Right now, I think we have a lot of data, but too many data, sometimes we cannot decide what is the real one, what is the wrong one. So you need some kind of the processing, you need some kind of the simulation and modeling, for example. So this technology permits you to simplify the idea and some kind of the forecasting and modeling. The third one is in telecommunication. The simple word is internet. Computer can connect to each other, and the data can flow. The people can use all kind of data. And the last one is the maybe the most important one is information.
Mm-hmm.
We need to know information. Many people believe that information is the very important asset. Yeah. So apart from four technologies, we invite the expert to give a talk to the researcher or to the private sector in NECTEC Asia 2009 that we organized the last week, I think, between the 23rd and 25th of September mm-hmm. this year.
So a lot of people came to listen
to
the concept.
Yes.
And what were the outcomes?
We organized the seminar, the conference, and also the exhibition. So in the seminar, I think we invite the expert around the world who know very well in some certain area that we focus. They tell us and tell us about the latest knowledge that the interval they are trying to do. And in the exhibition, we invite the people and researcher to exhibit the latest work, and the participants came and discussed with them directly.
Mm-hmm.
And we believe that between the discussion, the new idea can formulate, and we can have a new project, a new idea, for example.
So the idea of creative economy has been introduced by the government for quite some time. Let's say about 3 to 4 months we've been hearing this term floating around. But in terms of practicing, putting it into a place through technology and through helps from other related organizations, I mean, how possible do you think that this concept would be? And well, they say it's going to be really successful, but do you think it's going to take some time?
But in the real one, the creative economy exists already. But the government used the new another term like the knowledge economy.
Mm-hmm.
Creative economy is composed of, for example, the entertainment, animation, design, for example, is already there. I think this part of the creative economy is contributes some certain number, I don't know exactly, for our GDP.
So it is there already
for
some businesses,
but
not
right now, our government try to focus and emphasize that because we believe that if we emphasize in this area, we can, I think, create more value for Thai society.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of try to invest in term of the own economy that you need more people, more money that we don't have already. Now we have to convert the thing that in our brain mm-hmm. to be our product and our service. Maybe this is the concept. This is the best way to increase our value of economy.
In terms of technology itself here in Thailand, how ready are we with the technological infrastructure in providing help to the business operators?
We, as the government, try to divide the definition of creative economy into three areas. The first one is in term of the cultural and heritage. This is the idea is that how we can use this kind of the thing, the assets, to be more value.